All right, I'm gonna go ahead and take you out. Record only, thank God. Hello and welcome to the SpaSOS Business Master Class. Hello and welcome to the SpaSOS Business Master Class. My name is Sherrie Tennessee. I am the Director of Education for the SpaSOS. And today we are going to talk all about the topic of holistic education with Monique Blake. So with that, let me go ahead and bring her into the conversation. Hello, Monique. How are you today?
I'm great. Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. So a little bit about Monique Blake, a dear friend of mine. But in addition to that, she has an astounding background as a well-being expert, education coach, consultant with more than 20 years in the industry. She works on empowering individuals as well as organizations with the goal of ultimate well-being. Monique offers a variety of training, including personalized programs that really help facilitate living your best life, both professionally as well as personally. Monique, thank you so much for being with us today. I truly appreciate it. And then let me also make sure that I give a shout out to WellBEing TV. They are hosting the platform. Great information. And then there's also an opportunity if you're interested in hosting your own show, that is viable as well. This will air on WellBEing TV on all of their platforms, Instagram, LinkedIn, as well as Facebook. So thank you so much for WellBEing TV for hosting us today. So Monique, we had talked, we're both so passionate about education and training and sharing that with you. And, you know, when we were having our conversation about the show, you mentioned this concept of holistic education. What does holistic education mean to you?
Holistic education is, as the word implies, it looks at the entire picture, the whole picture of education. And it really is about, you know, making sure that you can create a signature brand through your training and ensure a quality in your training. So it's, I use the four P's.
Okay.
I talk about holistic education as the plan, the platform, the participants, and the progress. And
fantastic.
So,
oh, I'm sorry. So let's dive into that a little bit more. So as a trainer, you know, we kind of get that question on why is training so important. I think there's a great quote on if you train them, what happens if they leave? And the question, you know, they always say, well, what happens if they stay? So why do you think training is so important and so vital to a wellness spa organization?
Again, it really comes down to who you are as a brand. It's not just the marketing. It's not just you know, the pictures that you send out in your advertising. Ultimately, your brand is the platform for that is determined by the quality of service that you give. So it's really something training that's done well ensures a level of quality, and it ensures a true, authentic view of your brand. It's your signature.
Absolutely. So when I go to the shows and I speak about training and the importance, and I'm sure you've seen this as well, one of the challenges or one of the questions that I get on a regular basis is how do you get the buy-in from the manager? So when you talk about training, who should participate? And then how do you get that leadership to participate in the training?
That's a great question. So I know that a lot of technicians are always excited about training, and the same, a lot of people in management really want to have great quality training for their team and for their spa. So the who really is the technician, right? And one of the things that's important when you look at the who is to think about how they learn. So it doesn't matter the department in your spa, whether it's a hairstylist, a pedicure, manicure specialist, a facial specialist, a massage therapist, they tend to be kinesthetic learners.
Okay.
And so they need training that will, you know, not be just all theory, And that will have a very dynamic hands-on quality to it. So, you know, the who is really the team members, making sure that whatever training that you create is speaking specifically to their learning style. Mm-hmm. And also the other who is everybody else in the spa. One of the things that I see often when I do trainings is that the training is just the specific department. And there is no one else. There's no attendants. There's no front desk people. These are the people who are going to ultimately, you know, sell your service.
Right.
There's no management. One of the things I often do when I go and do a training is that I encourage management to get on the table, to get to be a part of the training. It's great because one, they actually get to feel the impact. They're also selling, right, you know, the service. They're also recommending it. And it also gives them a great time to interact with their team on a different level. True. They get to see, for example, I've done trainings and, you know, when the GM or the AGM or anyone from the management team participates, one of the things you often hear them say is that, oh my gosh, I didn't realize it took so much mm-hmm. for the technician to be able to perform at this level. So it creates this kind of greater understanding. Mm-hmm. It deepens the relationship. And it also really exposes everyone that has a hand in recommending the service to the service.
Absolutely. Absolutely. As a fellow massage therapist and trainer, it is impactful to get on the table and have that experience and feel and have that guest experience. And I think as we're talking about this, I think that's a great way to make sure that everyone knows what is happening in the room, from the receptionist to the attendant to the manager, director, GM, that they all have that experience, because you can convey it a little bit more than reading the words on the paper. That's so then right. Let me ask you this. As we are moving to a more high tech, what kind of platforms, if you can't necessarily get out, maybe you have your location that has 10 different or 12 different locations across the US, how do you provide that training when you may not always, it's so much information, as you said, it's theoretical and kinetics. How do you balance that out on a learning platform?
That's a great question. It really is, because I've worked with spas that just have one site. And most recently, I've worked with a salon that has 25 locations across the US. Mm-hmm. So finding a way to get this information to everyone in a way that is consistent mm-hmm. across the board is important. So, you know, there are different ways, there are different platforms. The platform is one of the key P's in the four P's, right? Because it offers many things. Mm-hmm. So there's e-learning, which is becoming online learning, which is becoming very popular. And it is a great tool. The only thing I would say is, you know, again, going back to the learning style, understand there is a way to optimize it for someone who is a more of a kinesthetic learner.
Right.
So you have the e-learning platforms, you have the live platforms, which is typically what the technician is most excited about. They're excited about getting hands-on training, you right. know, the experience. And then there's blended learning, which is really the best of both worlds.
Okay.
So blended learning is that you're presenting a part of the information online, mm-hmm. And then you present part of the information live, hands-on.
Okay.
And it's really, in my opinion, the best way to go, because, you know, training does have a cost, and this is one of the ways to minimize cost, as well as to create a level of consistency in training. If you're sending out a video to 25 locations, it's the same information being dispersed. Right. So I look at blended learning as an opportunity, like a prerequisite, so to speak. You can do a lot of the theory online. And so you can do the theory online. And then when you get to the live training, you focus mainly on the training. You may have room for a review of some of the theory or find a way to bring the theory into the live training. But the focus of having that one-on-one or face-to-face rather is to get the hands-on and not to spend so much time with the theory. With that said, I would like to say that I see a lot of online education that has an opportunity to kind of discourage learning. And some of that has to do with how they're presenting the online material.
Okay.
Number one, I always feel that it's very, very important to make the information digestible. And right. One of the ways to make it digestible is to give it in small increments. Mm. So there's an entire science behind this. Everything from if you're using PowerPoints to use a dark background because it's easier on the eyes, thinking about how much information you put on a slide.
Exactly.
You don't need to put an entire SOP on a slide. You can highlight the important right. points and then attach the SOP as a download, you know, as a handout so that they can download it and read it on their own. So it's very important to make it digestible. It's very important to make it engaging.
Right.
You know, take small amounts of information, take breaks in between the presentation to check in, to see if
how they're doing
the information before going on.
So, no, it's true. You see a lot of almost data dumping is what I call it, where they want to put every key point. It's almost a paragraph on a presentation slide. I'm reading this really great book or just finished it called Presentation Zen. And what he really talks about is you don't need the animation. You don't need all of the bells and whistles, like really just hone in on those key points that you want to convey. Because what he said, and I had never thought about this, and I am a visual learner, is you can't read and listen at the same time.
Exactly.
So if you just put like, say we're doing pregnancy massage or we're doing some sort of wellness technique, like just the name of it. So that's it. And then they can listen to everything that's being conveyed. I think we, you know, in addition to changing the model of spas where it is more education based, I think how we train and convey information, especially for me, because I am a true visual learner. I need to see it. I think that's why I gravitated to massage and was so successful is because you could touch it, you could feel it, you could have that in-room experience, and why I never could understand chemistry because I was like, I don't see those chemical reactions. I think a lot of people in the industry, having been an educator in this field for almost 18 years now, it's a big deal. So then that leads to the next one. So say you have this video that goes out to 25 locations. How do you ensure that that is being practiced, that it's being implemented to the level, and as kind of like what you said when you started, to ensure that the brand is being maintained? So how do you ensure that quality and application of the correct training?
Great question again. So that is, and you know, I think when I look at education and what I see in the field, not only in the spa industry, but you know, across the board in many industries, one of the pieces that's often left out is that progress part. You know, that checking in, that following up, not just the e-learning or the online learning component is also the hands-on component as well. So there are different ways that you can follow up. You know, there is this erroneous expectation that if I spend 6 hours, I'm just using that as an example, 6 hours in a training or a day-long training hands-on, that all of a sudden I'm a master at a technique. And that's not true in any way. So one of the things that I've always implemented in training is, you know, we have the theory online. We have checks, quizzes, you know, check-ins, reviews. That has to be, it's a prerequisite to the live component. Mm-hmm. once you get to the live component, you do the hands-on, you bring in the theory into the hands-on, right? Instead of taking an hour to do theory, you doing your hands-on, and as you're doing the hands-on, it's a refresher of the theory.
Yes.
And then once the hands-on is completed, there's a refresher period, a refresher training. And during this training time, whether it's 3 weeks, 6 weeks, whatever the length, depending on the intensity of the training, during that refresher training, people get to practice.
Yes.
They get to, you know, finally they have a question. You know, yes. As they're practicing, they realize that there's something that they didn't understand. And so during that refresher period, after that, there's a follow-up.
Okay.
You know, let's see if you really got it. Let's see if there are any questions. It doesn't have to be complicated. It's just these small steps are really important to ensure the quality. So it's very important, this progress part, because this is the one part that you don't see a lot in training.
It's true. It's kind of like customer service training, where it's like, here's your customer service training and you leave it in the room. And we both know as educators, repetition leads to retention. So the more you can repeat it, it's kind of like having to write your words, you know, 40 times when you were in school, you remember that word 40 years later, right? So that repetition definitely does lead to it. You've talked a lot about the training that you provide and the experience that you have. What training are you currently offering if someone is watching the show and they maybe want to bring you into their location? What kind of maybe specific trainings do you provide, or consulting services if they're interested in enhancing or creating training for an organization? Can you talk a little bit more about the services you actually provide?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things that I offer is really helping people get a clear plan for their training. That's, you know, when we talk about the four P's, that's the why. Why are you doing this training? Is it to maintain a certain standard of service? Is it to refresh skills? Or are you trying to bring something new, to be innovative, to kind of have a competitive edge, right? So anything along that line, you know, that what I do, no matter if it's on, for an organization or an individual, it has to be really personalized. So following that why system, I do things, everything from refreshing of massage skills. One of the biggest area is body mechanics.
Oh, yes.
And that is something that creates immediate and long-term results, right? You can keep your team member longer if they are using the proper body mechanics. So body mechanics, refreshing of massage skills, or just different modalities. I work with, I'm an Ayurvedic practitioner. I'm a certified, NAMA certified Ayurvedic practitioner. So Ayurveda, I do a lot with aromatherapy as well.
Okay.
And then of course, those are the more structured, more practical modalities. But I can definitely build a plan for something that is innovative, that's unique. If you want to create your own massage or body, I love hydrotherapy treatments. I definitely can create that. And then, of course, on the other end, I offer things that are a little bit more personal, but have a perfect fit into the wellness and spa arena. And so I have been teaching tarot and astrology for many, many years. And so those are things that you, actually, I was speaking to a lady who spent 32 years as an astrologer for a major spa brand.
Wow.
So those are the things that are a part of the wellness and the well-being equation as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's all encompassing.
Yeah.
So as we wrap up today, I always like to ask, what is one piece of advice that you would give the listeners in regard to this concept of holistic education?
My advice is simply invest in quality education. It is an investment. Did you have a question? I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know what I meant to ask you is how do you find that quality trainer?
Oh, yes. Quality trainers are, you know, they're really great trainers in the world. And how do you find them? Like you find anything else. Networking is a great way with spa associations and your colleagues. Word of mouth is still the best referral for many great trainers. A lot of times in you know, working with, looking for trainers, you can start with your team members as well. They're in the industry and a lot of times they have connections with excellent trainers. The other very interesting resource that people are turning to more and more today are their vendor partners. Vendor partners understand the value of quality education and the importance of it to kind of give, to highlight their products. So a lot of them have gone as far as not only creating quality education, but also creating education that is NCBTMB approved.
Right.
So that the team member is not only getting a training, but they're also getting continuing education units necessary to, and this is specifically for massage, but necessary to keep their license up to date. So those are some of the real important parts of looking for a quality trainer.
And then completing your original question of the one piece of advice. So you find this quality trainer, and then how do we utilize them or maximize that? I'm sorry.
No worries. So definitely invest in quality education. Make sure that whoever you're reaching out to, that you have some preview of what they're doing and that the information is just engaging, simple, dynamic, and most important, fun on some level.
Absolutely.
You know, if people are not having fun while they're learning. There's no memory. There's, you know, the experience is limited if they're not fully engaged. And making a learning fun is a great way to maximize engagement.
Absolutely. Yeah. There was a study that said people who laugh during learning tend to retain the information a little bit more, something about just those endorphins, and they remember those moments. So if people want to get in contact with you, you are at Being in Touch Inc. I think, is it Instagram is the number one platform for you?
Instagram is definitely the number one platform, but you know, feel free to reach out to me on Facebook. I'm also on LinkedIn. Okay. And that is a great resource for me. There's a lot of, it's very easy to get in touch with me on LinkedIn.
Absolutely. And I just want to take this time again to thank WellWorld TV for giving us this opportunity to have a conversation. And if anyone is interested in getting in contact with me directly, you can reach me at the Spa SOS on Instagram as well as Facebook. And with that, Monique, I just want to thank you again for taking the time to join us today, and I wish you much success. And let's hope that this concept of holistic education really does increase in our industry. We definitely need it probably now more than ever. With that, thank you so much and have a great day.
Have a good one. Thank you so much.
Thank you. All righty. Bye-bye.